Hey, what's up guys? I hope you are doing well. Sachin Mishram here once again. In this tutorial, we will learn an effect called glitch, which can be used in variety of ways. Glitch is a distortion, an interference and a defect that happens in electronic media. And we ended up visualizing this defects and interferences on our screen. Here, in the case of After Effects, I will show you how to simulate these defects and interferences. We use glitch in a variety of ways, including text, which is our case. But these effects that I'm going to teach can be used on anything, text, images, videos, etc. Now, before we get started today, I wanted to remind you to please subscribe to my YouTube channel, like and share. Let's start. I will create a pre-comp. I'm going to write glitch here. 1920 by 1080. I'm going to put in 10 seconds so it doesn't get too long. And let's get started. Now that we have created our composition, first thing I'm going to do is right click, new, text, edit glitch. Click further down to center and great. Let's leave this text a little aside. I come here with the right button, new, solid, and we are going to create a solid. I'm going to name it fractal noise, which is the name of the effect I'm going to add to it. Before that, I'm going to right click with it selected and I'm going to pre-comp this solid. Also with the name fractal noise is great. Great, comp created. I come in effects and presets, type fractal noise to find out our effect. I dragged up our layer. Great. Now let's configure this fractal noise. To configure, the only thing I ask to follow to the letter is here in noise type, put block. It leaves a different shape. This is how we should use it to make glitch look cool. The rest you can vary. It doesn't have to be the same. But in any case, you can follow it if you want what I'm going to do. Contrast, I'm going to put 250. Another thing I'm going to change about transform is scale. Only here I will click on this checkbox to separate the width and height scale, because I just want to touch the width. I will add 1000 beauty. Visually, that's all I need, but I need to move it. So I'm going to come to evolution, click on the stopwatch, press the U to show what has that frame, and here the first one is 0. I will put it in 10 seconds, put 10 laps, I think it's good. Here you don't have to worry about the timing of the composition. Great. Yes, right. We created fractal noise, which will be the basis for creating glitch. There is our main composition. I'm going to take this layer of fractal noise, put it down, and I'm going to hide this layer so it doesn't have to be visible. So I already delete to just view our text. And now the next step, right click, new, adjustment layer. The adjustment layer is an adjustment layer that when placed in it will affect everything underneath. It is as if you applied this effect in a single layer and you applied it to all the layers below. You only need to apply it once and all the layers under it will be affected. In our adjustment layer, I will come here and add an effect called Displacement Map. This one. Drag to the adjustment layer. Done. The Displacement Map is a distortion effect, but to be used, we need to have another layer to tell him how things will be distorted. And this layer is the one we created from fractal noise. I'm back on the adjustment layer, Displacement Map. Here he asks you to tell us which layer is. I come here, fractal noise. And that's it. He is using fractal noise to distort. You can see that it has already distorted a little bit, because it's in the minimum settings. But this is where our creativity comes from, to distort our will until we reach a satisfactory result. I will distort just for you to see, simulating these glitches. But you can see on my timeline that it is for the entire duration. And glitch only happens at certain points in one frame or another. It is the second that gives the interference. The ideal is that it is little by little. For that, I come at the end of the layer. When this double arrow appears, save and drag to leave you print this effect. I'm going to press more to zoom in. Here is just one frame, I will put 2. You will see that we already create a glitch. If I give it a play, and that from there. It's about using creativity. Explore and create the way you want and combine several glitches of that. For example, here I give a Ctrl plus D duplicate. Select and drag the layer forward. I put it in the beginning. It starts with a glitch that way. I have been drawing here, configuring the displacement, and I will join with the other. I can even put it under to combine the two together. You can see it gets even more intense. I can give another Ctrl plus D and put it further forward. But different. For example, I can put 0 here and just move it around. You will see that it will do the glitch effect. And I do this effect throughout the video. For example, there are 10 seconds. I'm finding it a lot. I will put the team to reduce the area. I will pull the text and end up so we can see on play as it enters. It starts by entering a glitch. Stay a while. And in the end, I'm going to do it in a glitch as I did in the example. Here it ends up creating several layers, so you might want to organize yourself. Glitches in the end as if it were an outgoing transition. Another thing I can do, I will show you, is to add a glitch in just a few parts. For this, you use a mask. You make a mask in the adjustment layer. I come here. I will just organize the layer. I come here in the square, in the rectangle tool, and do some glitches in just a few points. It is also cool to use this mask feature. It has different effects. I left a lot of frames. It is legal to leave 2, at most 3 to create this effect. It comes in a way and out of another. Here it is also nice to create small glitches throughout the video, smoother and more subtle so as not to interfere with the text visualization. You better pay attention and make sure that the text is being well visualized. Here in the case, I will add 1 for example. I will leave 10 here and 5 here. He made a small glitch which I can combine with smaller ones to duplicate the layer again. A little more subtle, but it helps to give movement to the text. It doesn't get in the way of reading so much. In this case, I left a lot of time. You can even add the strongest effect, but sometimes the time is shorter. You put the weakest effect just to show you don't get in the way of reading. For example, here I will put even stronger. Okay, this is our effect. You can also modify it here to your liking. We can do a test. For example, if I raise this here, we'll change our glitch a little bit. It changed a little. We can create more than one factor noise layer. Be able to use in different adjustment layers. In some, you use a layer, in others, another layer. So we create various forms of glitch. Finally, a bonus sometimes. In these glitches, we have what is called RGB split, which is a distortion in the color of the text. I like to do it when I do the glitch effect. It is very simple to do. We took our text. I will duplicate it twice, 1, 2, and I'm going to put the primary colors of the video, which are RGB, blue, green, and red. Here, I'm going to get the three together. I'm going to come here in color mode and put add for the three. They're adding in the video RGB. They added colors from white, going back to the original color. But here, I'm going to shift their position to get that effect. This is a concept that you can use in other ways. But the simplest is that way, changing and shifting colors, and also using blend mode by add. I'm going to shorten the timeline for us to watch. That's it. That was really cool. You can do it any way you want. We use this effect a lot in motion. You get incredible results with it. So, did you like glitch? In this tutorial, I showed you the text animation techniques I use the most and that you will probably also use. As usual, I invite you to post it on Instagram, tagging me and using the #MeshSachin hashtag. See you in the next tutorial. Thank you.